The United States has paused a large shipment of bombs to Israel, concerned that the munitions would be used during a large-scale invasion of Rafah. Despite the move, the IDF has moved into the outskirts of the city, seizing the border crossing and blocking aid shipments of desperately needed water and fuel. Any chance of peace now is also rapidly evaporating, with Hamas now threatening to walk away from peace talks completely.
A missile strike near tents that house the homeless. Rafah is the last shelter left for so many Palestinians, but Israel sees it as a Hamas stronghold, its military determined to control the southern city at any cost. The IDF's latest incursion, seizing the crucial border crossing, appears to be a limited operation, according to the US, and not the full-scale invasion Israel has been threatening. That is still coming, according to Israel's Prime Minister and the Defence Minister. This operation will continue until we eliminate Hamas in the Rafah area and the entire Gaza Strip, or until the first hostage returns. The border blockade means aid, again, cannot get through. The UN warns its teams will run out of fuel in the coming hours, preventing them from pumping drinking water and maintaining communications.
It's hard to see, if that closes for an extended period, how aid agencies avert famine across the Gaza Strip.
The crossings that have been closed need to reopen. It is unacceptable for them to be closed.
Also unacceptable for the US is a full-scale invasion of Rafah. The UK now says that would break international law. Britain's Deputy Foreign Minister wouldn't detail what consequences Israel would face if a much wider offensive goes ahead. For Israel's part, that seems all but inevitable, putting it on a dangerous collision course with its allies. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.